Five justices, Catherine Bamgemereire, Eva Luswata, Irene Mulyagonja, Muzamil Chibedi, and Oscar Kihika have ruled that the Speaker of Parliament had no quorum when she suspended MP Zake over a Facebook post he made about her, among other reasons. The ruling, read by the Registrar of Court, indicated that the Speaker's actions were illegal since she did not have a required quorum to impeach an officer of Parliament.
The adoption of the report of the Standing Committee on Rules, Privilege and Discipline on the inquiry into allegations of misconduct and misbehavior against the petitioner in the absence of the requisite quorum of at least one-third of all voting members of Parliament was inconsistent with or in contravention of Articles 2, 1 and 2, 88, 94(1) of the Constitution.
Speaker Among was advised to stop acting like the police, prosecution as well as judges. She was ordered to compensate MP Zake half of the costs he incurred at a 1% interest.
The order to annul the report of the Committee on Rules and Privilege on the investigation against the alleged misconduct and misbehavior of Honorable Francis Zake Butebi is denied. Parliament may implement the recommendations in the report in conformity with the law. C. The respondent shall pay one half of the costs of this petition to the petitioner.
Speaking after court, MP Zake was excited by the court ruling and scoffed at the Speaker Among, who had ordered for his impeachment.
That the legislature, as the arm of government, does not follow the law. It is very unfortunate that the legislature that is supposed to make laws itself is not following the laws. Today, it has been so clear. And I want to state that Madam Anita Among, she is not supposed to be called the Right Honorable Speaker. She's a wrongful one because she doesn't follow the law.
Zake, joined by other people, insisted that the impeachment was unconstitutional since Parliament lacked the required quorum of more than 240 members of Parliament to have him impeached.
Took me to the disciplinary committee. Actually, she's supposed to get there. Reason being, she has ashamed Parliament of Uganda. And she's the one supposed to be in that committee. And I want to call upon my fellow members of Parliament to begin on that one. Because she has been behaving, and she's still behaving, as a dictator. But she has been checked today. She thought she's untouchable, but today she has been touched. It is 1-0 now.
Just, and there's something called natural justice. That is what the court emphasized, that Anita Among did not follow the rules of natural justice. She was a prosecutor, she was an investigator, and she was a judge in her own cause. So we want to congratulate Honorable Zake, and we hope that Parliament will respect this decision and ensure that Honorable Zake is reinstated immediately as Commissioner of Parliament.
That court this morning, they advised her to follow the law in implementing any recommendations from any committee, and it always to adhere to quorum, which she ignored. It is therefore important that if she's going to continue harassing Honorable Zake, she must find a Trojan horse.
On March 17, 2022, Zake petitioned the Constitutional Court on grounds that he was unlawfully removed from his job and asked the court to reinstate him. His impeachment came after he was found guilty of breaching the rules of Parliament when he allegedly used his social media to attack and abuse the then Deputy Speaker of Parliament. And despite numerous requests to apologize, he declined, stating that Among had to apologize to him, first for claiming that he was not tortured as alleged by security operatives. According to Zake, Speaker Among wrote on her social media page that he lied about being tortured since he was able to run and win medals in the East African Parliamentary Games. Rachel Nashuala reporting for the news.